Welcome to lecture 8 on module 1 of computer organization, in which we will be discussing about the memory locations and the address, which includes the byte addressability, word alignment, as well as the big Indian, little Indian, along with some of the memory operations. In this particular slide, we will be looking into the memory location and the address. As we know, a memory is a device that consists of many millions of storage cells, and each cells will have one bit of information, either it is 0 or 1. This information is very minute so that it can be accessed. So in order to avoid this, the better approach is to group a number of bits together and address it or transfer it or process it wherever required. And this group of bits is called as the word, and the number of bits in that group represents the word length. The memory of computer can be schematically represented as the collection of words. Here, in this particular diagram, we have represented that there is a first word, second word, ith word, and the last word. Each word will have one address. Each word will have one address using which the memory is accessed. We have already discussed about this in our previous lectures. We have also discussed how this address is generated, or how the addresses are formed. So each group of word will have one address. Based on the word length, the first word may have 8 bit, 16 bit, or 32 bit, and so on. The most of the modern computers have the word length that is typically in the range of 16 to 64 bits. So what happens is, if we need to identify each word with the distinct name, that is address. So how this address is calculated? We know that if there are 16 address locations or 16 address locations, we need to generate 16 distinct address that should be in binary. So it becomes 2 power 4. So here this 4 is the address lines. It can be represented in powers of 2. So 16 byte space, if you want to address a 16 byte space, then you need 4 address lines. Similarly, if you can generate, or if you want to address 1 kilobytes of memory, 1 kilobyte, that is 1024. If you want to address 1 kilobytes, then you can represent it in terms of 2 power 10. You need 10 address lines. You need 10 address lines in order to address 1024 byte or word locations. If you want to address 1024 bytes or word locations, then you need 10 address lines. Next, we will discuss about the byte addressability. So this byte addressability means a minimum size of word length that can be accessed. See, as we discussed in our previous slides, the word length can range from 16 to 64 bits in modern computers. But we cannot directly assume a word length to be 64 bits, because most of the instructions, even though the computer system is of 64 bit size, most of the instructions may not be of 64 bit length. Some of the instructions may be of 8 bit length, some of them may have 16 bit length, some of them may have in 32 bit, and so on. But what happens if we address them with a 64 bit word length, most of the times we will be wasting the memory. In order to avoid that, the better option is to have a word length of 8 bits. So such kind of addressing is called as byte addressable memory. A byte means nothing but a group of 8 bits. So the term byte addressable memory, in which each word will be having a size of 8 bits. In case of byte addressable memory, the address of individual memory location will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, it continues. Each word will be of 8 bit size, 8 bit, and the address will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Whereas if the size of the word is 16 bit or 32 bit, then the address of each word will be, in case of, if it is 32 bit, then it will be 0, 4, 8, 12 and so on, with the offset of 4, where in case of 32 bit word length. In case of byte addressable memory, it is offset of 1. Each byte will have one address. That's what the byte addressable means. In this case, we will be discussing about the Big Endian and the Little Endian assignments. This Little Endian or the Big Endian is the way in which the data are transferred and stored in a memory. For example, in case of Big Endian, if the lower order byte is stored in higher order address, then it is Big Endian. Similarly, if the lower order byte is stored in lower order address, then it is called as Little Endian. If you are transferring some data, for example, let me assume 8015, I want to transfer 8015 number from a processor to memory. Now there are two ways in which I can transfer it. In one case, let me assume I have the address 0123. And similarly, I have one more memory 0123. So now this 15 is termed as least significant byte, whereas this 80 is considered as most significant byte. Now, if this least significant byte occupies the lower order address, now lower order address means 0 is the lower order address as compared to 1. Now, if I store 15 here and the higher order byte or the MSB in the address 1, this type of assignment is considered as Little Endian assignment. Whereas, if I store this 15 in the higher order address and most significant byte in the lower order address, then this type of assignment is called as Big Endian assignment. Here in this diagram, see here, the 0th word address will have 0th byte, next first byte, second byte and third byte. Now here, this is the least significant byte. This is the least significant byte. So what happens is, lower order byte will be stored in higher order address. Now this is the higher order address compared to 3 in this assignment. So it is Big Endian. Whereas in case of Little Endian, 0 lower order byte will be stored in lower order address. This is the lower order, this is the higher order. This is the lower order, this is the higher order. Now the 0 will go and sit in higher order in case of big endian, whereas the 0th byte will sit in lower order address in case of little endian. That is the only difference between the little endian and the big endian mode of assignments. The word locations have the aligned address if they begin at byte address that is multiple of number of bytes in a word. That means if you have a 16-bit word, that means it has two bytes. So it is said to be aligned if they begin at the byte address that is multiple of number of bytes. So in case of a 16-bit word length, the number of bytes is two. So the memory is said to be word aligned only if you have the address of multiple of bytes, that is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. In such cases, the memory is said to be word aligned. Similarly, if you have a 32-bit word length, then the number of bytes in a 32-bit word is 4. So the word address should be the multiple of 4, that is 0, 4, 8, 12 and so on. Similarly, if it is a 64-bit word length, then a single word will have 8 bytes. So the address should be in the offset of 8 bits, 0, 8, 16, 24, 32 and so on. This is called the word alignment. If suppose the word belongs with arbitrary values, for example, if we'll take the first case of 16-bit word length 0, if suppose it becomes 1, then word address as 0, the next location will be word address 1. If suppose this happens, then this kind of alignment is called as unaligned alignment. It is not word aligned, it is unaligned. Accessing the numbers and the characters. However, all the examples whatever we have seen in the previous slides is of accessing the numbers, which is of very simpler way of accessing one word. The word length may be of any size depending on the processor. The individual characters can be accessed by their byte address. The characters are having a 8-bit representation, that is in terms of ASCII number, and each character can be having a single byte address by which it can be accessed. It is necessary to handle the character strings of variable length. So in order to see in that case the successive address will have successive characters of a string. Two ways to indicate the length of a string, that is the end of a string and a separate memory word location or a processor register. In case of end of the string, there will be a special character at the end of the string. When the processor encounters that special character, it indicates that there is the end of the string. Whereas the other approach is to have a particular register that holds the number of characters in a string. As and when all the characters are accessed, the register will become null, which indicates that the processor has accessed all the characters in a string. This is how the characters can be accessed. Memory operations. We know the importance of memory. These memories are used to store the program instructions as well as the data. All this program as well as the data corresponding to that particular program are stored in memory. To execute an instruction, it is necessary for a processor control circuit to transfer the word containing the instruction to the processor. The two basic operations involving the memory are needed, that is load operation and the store operation. The load operation transfers a copy of contents of a specific memory location to the processor, whereas the store operation transfers the item from the processor into a memory. These are the two operators that are used in order to transfer the data from the memory to the processor or from processor to the memory.